standard 3rd subject English grammar. In last lecture we were doing chapter 5 comma. Now today we are doing chapter 6 nouns. Let's see words that we say. All right, are divided into different groups. जो words हम बोलते हैं, जो words हम लिखते हैं, वो words different groups में divide किया गया है. So according to the word they do in a sentence, वो sentence में हम arrange करते हैं, वो सारे words को हम sentence में arrange करते हैं. These groups are called parts of speech. वो सारे words के groups है, उसको हम क्या कहते हैं? Parts of speech. उसको हम क्या कहते हैं? Parts of speech. जो words है वो different groups में divide है, उसे हम कहते हैं parts of speech. There are 8 parts of speech. How many parts of speech? There are 8 parts of speech. So let's see. Number 1, noun. Number 2, adjective. Number 3, pronoun. Number 4, verb. Number 5, adverb. Number 6, preposition. Number 7, conjunction. Number 8, interjection. Means if you write or say any sentences, in all sentences that include these parts of speech, वो सारे sentences में noun, adjective, pronoun, verb, adverb, preposition, conjunction, interjection, ये सारे 8 parts of speech उसमें include होते हैं. Now in this chapter we will discuss only nouns. Another parts of speech that we will discuss later on. Today, now we are doing only discuss about noun. Let's see exercise A. Fill in the boxes. So let's see number 1. This is the name of a place. So here we have to write name of a place. So aapko kaun si place yaad aati hai? Yes, main yahan pe likh rahi hu school. The word school is the name of a place. So I write the spelling of school. S-C-H-O-O-L, school. Yes, aapko pata hai ki school hai wo place hai. And keep in your mind, in all boxes everybody write down in capital letter only. Don't use small letter. Next, number 2. This is the name of the boy. Here we have to write the name of the boy. Rahul. So I write Rahul. R-A-H-U-L. Rahul. All the letters write in capital letter. Now next, number 3. This is the name of non-living thing. वो नॉन लिविंग थिंग है, वी कीप बुक्स इन इट, हम उसमें बुक्स रखते हैं, तो वो क्या है, वो क्या चीज है? बैग. सो आई राइट द स्पेलिंग ऑफ बैग, बी ए जी बैग. नेक्स्ट नंबर 4, दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द गर्ल. सो हियर आई राइट द नेम ऑफ द गर्ल. यहाँ पे मैं गर्ल का नेम लिखूंगी रिंकी. R-I-N-K-I, रिंकी. सो द नेम ऑफ अ प्लेस, द नेम ऑफ अ बॉय, द नेम ऑफ अ थिंग, द नेम ऑफ अ गर्ल आर कॉल्ड नाउंस. उसे कहते हैं नाउंस. नाउ लेट्स सी नंबर 5. दिस इज द नेम ऑफ द एनिमल. सो आई राइट हियर डॉग. यहाँ पे मैं डॉग का नेम लिखूंगी, डी ओ जी डॉग. डॉग इज द नेम ऑफ एन एनिमल. सो नाउन्स आर द नेम्स ऑफ पर्सन्स, प्लेसेस, एनिमल्स, बर्ड्स एंड थिंग्स आर कॉल्ड नाउन्स. उसे कहेंगे नाउन्स. नाउ आई विल एक्सप्लेन by showing these flashcards. Look at these flashcards. Which spelling is this? Yes, the spelling of hospital. So can you tell me? Hospital we have to include it in which? Person, place, animal, bird or thing? Yes, I will tell you. The word hospital is the name of a place. So we can call the word hospital is a noun. Now let's see next word. Which word is here? F-A-N, fan. So fan we have to include it in thing. And also the word fan is called a noun. Now next word. Which word is given? Mahak. So the word mahak is the name of a person. Ultimately, name of a person we can call a noun. So the word mahak is called a noun. Next, L-I-O-N, lion. So the word lion is the name of an animal. So ultimately, animal includes noun. So the word lion is the name of a noun. Now let's see from these exercise. School. School is the name of a place. Rahul is the name of the boy. Bag is the name of a thing. Rinki is the name of a girl. Animal. Dog is the name of an animal. All the words you have written are nouns. ये सारे words हमने लिखे वो nouns से लिखे हैं. They are the names of persons, a thing, an animal or a place. वो क्या है? Names of persons. यहाँ पे persons के name है राहुल, रिंकी. A thing. तो thing में क्या है? Bag. And animal. Animal में क्या है? Dog. और a place. Place में क्या लिखा हमने? School. So now I'll tell you the definition of noun. Names of persons, animals, places and things are called nouns. I repeat. Names of persons, animals, places and things are called nouns. Means if we want to find nouns from the sentence, we have to find names of persons, places, animals, birds and things. Now let's see exercise B. I'll read the instruction of this exercise. Underline the nouns in the following story. इस एक्सरसाइज में आपको क्या करना है? नाउन है उसके नीचे अंडरलाइन करना है. आई रिपीट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ नाउन्स. नाउन्स आर द नेम्स ऑफ पर्संस, प्लेसेस, एनिमल्स, बर्ड्स एंड थिंग्स आर कॉल्ड नाउन्स. नाउ फ्रॉम दिस स्टोरी वी हैव टू फाइंड द नेम्स ऑफ पर्संस, प्लेसेस, एनिमल्स, बर्ड्स एंड थिंग्स. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई रीड द स्टोरी एंड आई एक्सप्लेन. Five mice live happily in a big house. Mice is a plural noun. Means we are talking about five mice. वो house में happily live कर रहे हैं. But one day, लेकिन एक दिन, the master of the house brings a cat to scare them. उसको डराने के लिए मास्टर है वो क्या लेके आए? कैट को लेके आए. द माइस आर स्केर्ड एंड कैन नॉट कम आउट ऑफ देयर होल्स. वो माइस है वो डर गए. कैन नॉट कम आउट ऑफ देयर होल्स मतलब होल्स में से बाहर नहीं निकलते हैं क्योंकि वो लोग कैट से डरते हैं. सो दे होल्ड अ मीटिंग. उन्होंने एक मीटिंग रखी. दे थिंक ऑफ मेनी आइडियाज. उन्होंने बहुत सारे आइडियाज सोचे. बट नन ऑफ देम इज यूजफुल. लेकिन एक भी आइडिया उनका यूजफुल नहीं रहा. फाइनली दे थिंक ऑफ अ प्लान. फाइनली उन्होंने प्लान बनाया माइस ने टू पुट अ बेल अराउंड द नेक ऑफ द कैट। चलो हम कैट की नेक में बेल लगा देते हैं। दे थिंक ऑफ अ प्लान टू पुट अ बेल अराउंड द नेक ऑफ द कैट बट नॉट इवन वन माइस अग्रीज टू टेक द रिस्क ऑफ गोइंग नियर द कैट। लेकिन एक भी माइस ने उसके नजदीक जाने के लिए रिस्क नहीं लिया। बट नॉट इवन वन माइस अग्रीज टू टेक द रिस्क ऑफ गोइंग नियर द कैट। मतलब एक भी माइस सारे माइस के साथ अग्री नहीं हुए जाने के लिए, कोई भी रिस्क लेना नहीं चाहते हैं। नाउ फ्रॉम दिस स्टोरी वी हैव टू फाइंड नाउंस। So let's read and find nouns. Five mice live happily in a big house. From this sentence, which words are nouns? The word mice is called a noun. The word house is called the noun. House is the name of a place. Mice are called animals. Next, but one day, yes, the word day also we have to include it in noun. The master of the house brings a cat to scare them. Yes, master we have to include it in person. So also we can call a noun. Again we have to underline the word house. Because house is the name of a place. Brings a cat is the name of an animal to scare them. The mice, we have to do the underline. The word mice is called a noun. Are scared and cannot come out of their holes. Holes we can call included in place. Ultimately it is called a noun. So they hold a meeting also we have to include it in noun. The word meeting is called a noun. They think of many ideas. Yes, the word ideas we can call a noun. So we have to underline the word ideas. But none of them is useful. Finally, they think of a plan. Yes, the word plan is called a noun. So we have to do the underline on the word plan. To put a bell, name of a thing. So we have to include it in noun. The word bell is called a noun. Around the neck. Neck is the body part. So we have to do the underline word neck. And the word neck is called a noun. Of the cat is an animal. We have to do the underline and it is called a noun. But not even one mice, we have to do the underline again, agrees to take the risk. The word risk is called a noun. Of going near the cat. Again we have to do the underline on the word cat because the word cat is an animal and it is called a noun. So here exercise B completed.
आभार